Hey guys, I'm just waiting for the stationery to come. I know I've seen some faces in the hallway. I saw that people were either bored, they were questioning themselves why they were here, and the funny Indian guy was laughing at them. That's me. Okay. Okay. So my sessions are always it's not monotonous. It's always two-way session. So today in my session I had created a slide deck, but I'm not using it. Okay. Last minute changes. I know I'm walking myself in a disaster. But yeah. So I'm interested to do some activities and not just deliver some content. I want you guys to work on something, and from that probably we'll make a curry. But you have to get the bread. That's all, not on me. I'm not getting the bread for you guys. Sorry. That's all a joke. Okay. Okay. I'm still waiting for the paper to arrive. Once it's here, probably we'll start the session. But in the meanwhile, let me introduce myself. My name is Prathamesh. I'm a technical support engineer working for Red Hat in Pune, India. But at the same time, I'm a volunteer for Mozilla. So I'm a community manager who is taking care of the global Mozilla community and kind of acting as a voluntarily project manager for them, helping them with some projects for the community. And I've been doing this for a lot of time, and that's the reason I thought of proposing a talk in DevConf, which can help me to share my experience of making a curry with simple ingredients in it. All right, I hope the paper is here. Good. Thank you. Yeah, you can just distribute. Okay, so how many of you are community managers? Anyone a community manager so far? Very good question. So community is nothing but a group of people. Agreed? Yes? So have you worked with people and helped them to get them into some specific direction? Have you mentored people as a group of people? Have you mentored a community? A group of people. So when I say community, it's group of people. Okay. A community could be any community. It could be a community doing yoga together in the morning, or PUBG community. We have a lot of PUBG communities in India. Those kids play PUBG games all the time. Then we have Linux communities. We have Mozilla communities. Communities, group of people. Okay. So have you ever worked with a group of people in such a way that you are asking them to do something for you or for the project? Yes? Okay. So I assume most of you have some idea about managing few people, right? Okay, but in this session, I'm going to do something different. Okay, I will take you out from the very typical space which we work every day, as in the communities which we work every day, and we are going to do something new, which I've never done so far in any of my sessions, and which is starting with a diagram. Okay, so I want you to have 2-3 papers, if you can, and some pens. Let me know once everyone is ready. Don't look there, I'm not using my slide deck. And I've been instructed that the camera can only cover this screen, so I cannot come out. Okay. I'm wearing good clothes, as far as I know, so. Okay, how many of you are technical people, as in technical engineers? Engineers, anyone? People from science, pure sciences. Okay, people from commerce background, as in commerce, day-to-day commerce, or arts. Okay, good. Okay, so now, how many of you have ever heard of any startup or worked with a startup? I'm just asking some questions so that I can channelize my session. Okay, good. How many of you want to transform the world? Transform the world? Okay. So now, I want you to think of one idea on which you would like to have your own startup, or your project, or a product. Okay, example, I'm single. Okay, it's a very funny example. I'm Indian, I'm single. Funny, ha ha ha. Okay, so I've always dreamed of a project which will create a virtual girlfriend. Okay, that's single guys in India think of virtual girlfriend. Okay, so a girlfriend, a Cybertron, probably. So my the project which I would like to work on could be a virtual girlfriend. Okay, I don't want to have a physical girlfriend because I don't have money. So I would like to have a virtual girlfriend. Okay, so that is one project which I have in my mind. That might be my idea. Okay, so do you have any idea in your mind on which you would like to create a project or have your own startup or product? Please write it down. So some people want to create VR applications. They want to have a startup which will have some VR application. My startup, yes. No, it could be anything. You want to take yoga to next level. That is your project or startup, you don't know. Anything, any idea, it could be technical or non-technical. I just want you to write in one sentence, what is that idea? We are not going to use anyone's or abuse anyone's copyright, okay? The idea is his idea. Don't copy it looking at what is the reality. Yes, please write one idea. You have 30 seconds. It could be any funny idea, out of the box. I want to have my own bank. Might be an idea, your project, right? I want to have my own cryptocurrency. Who's going to stop you? You have written your idea? Awesome. Done?
Yeah.
Everyone? Or should I wait? Done?
Yeah.
Okay. So now, based on one line of sentence which you have written, I want to answer three questions below. Okay. The question is, why, how, what? Why you want this to be your idea? How you want this idea to prosper? Or what all things you have in your mind based on this idea? For example, the why for virtual girlfriend is because I'm single. The how for virtual girlfriend is probably creating an AR application, augmented reality or mixed reality. And the what will be a girlfriend looking girlfriend, some celebrity.
Why?
Yes, why, how, what, the three questions. What? It could be anything. For example, let's say a person has written yoga or taking yoga to next level. What could be what you actually want to achieve? What do you mean by next level? Or defining the what for that idea? What exactly is that idea? A description or something. Please write it on a paper. And you can be descriptive as much as you can. Okay, how many of you have done writing those 3 points? Okay. Can you just give me your paper?
Not me.
It's fine. You can. People can always ask whose shit is this. Probably. But make sure that it's not the same paper on which you have written it. Yeah, she's. Okay, all done. So I want you to read what the person has written. And if you're not able to understand, please raise your hand and we'll find out who has written that shit. So that you can understand what he has written. Anyone finding it difficult so far to read?
I just finished my first one,
sorry. Oh, okay, we can, yeah. Okay, done? Have you read through the entire paper of the three things? Okay, now you have to, okay, sure. So now you have to reverse, on the back side of the page, you have to write something which I'll tell you, okay. What are the challenges you see in that idea, in those three questions? Do you find any challenge? It could be technical challenge, non-technical challenge. It could be anything. Some challenge which you think could be a challenge with these three questions or the idea, entire idea. If let's say a person has written to design a rocket which can take him to Mars, you can question what fuel you would be using or how you are going to, do you have finance? Generic questions, just ask those generic questions to that person. Yes, the back side, yeah, the back side. Yes, so if you have any questions related to that idea, the problems which you think might come implementing that idea, all the questions you are going to write it down on the back side of the page. But this time, make sure that you read through the entire thing and ask wise questions. So much wise that that person should not sleep tonight. He should only think of the answers of your questions. Ask as many questions as you can, as in write as many questions as you can. You can have more 5 minutes, not a problem. You can ask 10 questions, 20 questions. For example, if let's say the person has said that he wants to have a, let's say, any software product. So you can also ask him questions that while hiring team for your organization, will you consider the diversity factor as well? Such questions you can ask. Think out of the box, but ask wise questions. If the person says that he wants to design a rocket which can take him to Mars, you can also ask him what is the communication way you are going to have in your rocket which can help you to communicate with Earth. Any question. The shooting questions. But ask as much questions, as many questions as you can. Yeah, if you think that there could be more challenges as well to that idea, and if you have finished asking the questions, you can add more challenges as well.
It's okay if you have.
Yeah, it's okay. That's fine. If you have understood the idea, that means the person who has written it is crystal clear with his definition or with his idea, which is good. Okay, done. Can someone help me to collect all the papers, please? So now he is again redistributing it randomly again. All right, this is where the interesting part is. So you got your bike, you need to swap it. It should be a paper which you have not worked so far, on which you have not worked so far. All right? So now, this is the best part. The questions which the previous person has asked, you have to write the solution of it. If someone has asked questions previously, you have to answer those questions with respect to that idea, as if that is your own idea. And after that is going to be the best part, trust me. But you have to try to answer as much as questions, as many questions as you can. So what we have done so far? We have an idea. Okay? We have someone who has challenged your idea. Now we are trying to find solutions to those challenges. Okay? And then something will follow. If you are not able to read, please raise your hands. We can ask the person again. There could be some questions which you might not be able to answer. Okay, you can try your best. I'm not saying try. You can try your best. If not, that's fine. Okay, can you
just... It's about building the tag. Let's build the tag. It's a robot.
Let's build a robot.
Oh, nice. It's robot in tag.
More 5 minutes, all right? Don't stress yourself. It's fine if you're not able to answer everything. Done? tried answering most of the questions. Most of it. Okay? So what was the first thing which we did? Understanding the idea. Yes? Anyone had rough experience or unique experience while understanding the idea? Was there something which you found very unique? Anyone? It was the idea was very unique. Or I could not understand that. Yes. Okay.
And then others will help you out in a collaborative effort.
Okay.
To what challenges are going to be there and what potential solutions will be there for the same thing.
Okay. So while writing the idea, was there any challenge? No? Yes? Yes, no?
Just thinking of it to begin with, that's
all. Idea was not a challenge?
Just thinking of it.
Just thinking of it. Okay. Then defining the idea, was it a challenge? The why, how, what, was it a challenge? Yes? Anyone wants to give a try? What was the challenge while defining the three questions? What, why, how? Yes.
So I found that answering the why, what, how easier than coming up with the idea in the first place. I mean, part of me was thinking, oh, if I had like an amazing startup idea, probably would have tried it already or anything like that. There's the why, what, how did help to kind of go, oh, actually, yeah.
Okay, so you thought there could be some challenge in defining the three questions for that idea.
I think the challenge was more in the idea itself, the question.
Okay. Okay, so the challenge was in the idea itself. Okay. Any other challenge which anyone faced while answering the three questions, the why, what, how? No? Okay, moving on. What was the next thing which we did? We changed papers. And we asked you to find whether there could be any challenge in that idea, another three questions. Was it complicated for you to, you know, ask a question? No? Was it quite easy for you to list down all the questions? Or you were still struggling to ask the right question? Were you able to ask the right question personally, if you personally ask me, or if you personally introspect? Were you able to ask the right questions? Yes?
It was definitely easier to say, oh, here are all the things that are wrong.
Okay, okay. Okay, so asking questions was very easy than the rest two things, the two things which we did before, right? Okay, now answering the questions, was it difficult or it was easy? It was more difficult. Can you just give me one example? As in, what was the idea? What were the questions asked?
Some of the questions were not
very pointed. Can you be loud?
So, yes. Sorry?
Yeah, can you be loud?
Oh, yeah. Some of the questions didn't really apply or weren't exactly, didn't make sense for
okay.
The idea. So, broadly speaking,
okay.
It's not easy to ask the right questions.
Okay.
So when you're answering them, it's very difficult because you're like, well, you didn't ask the right questions. So how am I supposed to answer?
Okay, okay. Was there any different experience with answering the questions? Was it something that you started laughing looking at the idea in the first place? And then you thought it could be challenging to answer the questions? Okay, so the why, what, how was not clear.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. And while answering the questions, did you thought that you should speak with someone else or consult someone?
Yes.
Yes? Definitely. Okay. So now, what we did was, there was an idea, treat it as a project. There was one project. Okay. We were asked to find something which is not working right for the project. Okay. Then we ourselves, when we changed to new project, we aligned ourselves thinking it's my own idea. And now I need to answer the questions which someone has asked me. Correct? That is when your project management skills start. That's the first thing which you need to do. Understand the idea. All right? Once you have understood the idea, asking questions. Why am I contributing or why should I be a part of that project? All right? once you have these three questions, as in what is the project, why the project, how is the project, okay? Once you ask these three questions, you have the answers, then you start pointing to the project, as in what's wrong with that project, okay? Once you have answers to all the questions to your project, that is when you are very clear with what the project is. And this is when you can actually start speaking to other people what this project is all about and why you should come or contribute to this project in the first place. Okay, so whenever you think of getting into project management, this is the first thing which you need to do. The project could be anything. For me, it was Mozilla Firefox. Firefox was a project, but getting more people contributing to Firefox was a challenge to me. Okay. And now what I did was I understood the entire project, I asked the right questions to the right people, got the answers, and I could explain the same thing to the other people. Okay, and this is how I started influencing people to answer by answering their questions. Okay, if you are able to answer queries, trust me, people are going to ask you more questions, and that is when you start building bond. Okay. Then what happened was, after we had answers to few, when we were trying to, you know, answer questions, we were having some doubts in our mind, or we were thinking of some other person who can help us with this. Okay, that is when collaboration plays a big picture. In open source or in generic any organization, people cannot work efficiently without collaborating with others, and that's the reason we have multiple teams in the first place. Okay. Collaboration is the success to any project, and that is when we start thinking of the next steps. Okay, project manager or a community manager has to have a bond with the community, as in with a group of people, and collaborate with other stakeholders at the same time. Okay, so the idea of this exercise was to make you understand that project management or community management is not that difficult. Okay. If you have the right set of actions, you can easily get into community management. How many of you felt that it was a big disappointing exercise for me? Was this exercise out of your mind, or you were not able to do anything? Was there anyone in this particular situation? You were stuck. I cannot take it further. Now that you know that you are convinced with the idea, you were able to answer the questions, you can obviously take it forward with other people. Was this the feeling? Or it was not the feeling at all? Then, in that case, you can switch the project. Okay. So now, how many of you are inspiring community managers? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Out of 20, 30, 25 people, we have 3 people who are inspiring community managers. What do you think? After this exercise, can you at least talk with people?
Yeah.
Can you express the idea which the project stands for?
Yes.
That was something which I wanted to stress in this talk. As in, community management is not something out of the box. If you know the project, if you know what it stands for, and if you can deliver it to other people, as in if you can talk with other people, that is when you're actually being a community manager. Okay. Any questions so far with this activity? Any questions? Now I can turn to my slide deck. Okay, so this is the community. Okay. Okay, so what do you think are the most important elements of a community? Now we are coming to the next part, after the post-exercise part. What do you think is the most important element of any community?
People.
People? Okay. Object.
Project.
What else? People and project.
Openness.
Yes.
Openness.
Okay.
Rules.
Yes.
Rules.
Rules. Okay. Okay. So framework. Can we say framework?
Yeah.
Okay. What else?
Moderators.
Yes.
Moderators.
Okay. Stakeholders. Can we say stakeholders? Okay. What else? Expectations. Good. So the most important elements of a community is the people, right? The project for which the people are working for, and what is the expectation from the project stakeholders and from the people who are working for the project. If you have that particular thing in mind, trust me, you could be good at managing communities. Not just one community, I'm saying communities. Okay, that was the best part which I ever found in my life when during the time of managing it, that if you know the expectations from the project, from the people, trust me, you are going to go great. Okay, and this is nothing but the art of community which I taught, collaboration-driven approach. Everyone agrees that collaboration is required?
Yes.
Yes? Open communications.
Definitely.
Eden said openness, open communications. Everyone is contributing to that project because he has some expectations out of it. Okay, that expectation could be in the form of swags, it could be in the form of monetary benefits, it could be form of learning something. And that's the reason openness or open communication plays a very important role for people to bind together. Okay, the next is unwrapping the opportunities. People are not contributing to the project just for the sake of doing it or they have been forced to do it. No. They find something is there for them in that particular project, and that's the reason they're contributing to that project. And unwrapping the opportunity is something which the project manager or the community manager needs to focus on. How he can make the most of the communities to work on the project, and what can make the community more enthusiastic or leaned towards that project. Becoming the community. You, in the first exercise, when we started with the exercise, we saw what the idea was. So we thought as if it is my own idea and I need to challenge that idea, right? So getting into the boots of the community is very important when it comes to managing the community. You know, you should understand why the community stands for the first place, what is the goal of the community, okay? And then comes moving forward. As in, let's say the project is done, but what next? So let's say testing of one version is done, the community always is hungry. It always asks, what is next for me? So you should always work on getting more and more opportunities for the community. Okay. That was something which I wanted to get in my talk. We are running out of time. Do you have any questions so far with community management? Okay. I want to ask you one question. Let's say if there is a conflict in the community, what all things will you do? Let's say that the idea which you just had, there are people fighting for something. What is the basic thing which you'll do? If there is a conflict in a community, what is the thing which you... Okay, asking whether it's a conflict about the idea or conflict of contribution.
Yeah.
Okay, in community what happens is people are working for one goal. That is achieving the end success of the project. Okay, but let's say that you see a lot of people contributing or fighting over their contributions, as in saying that that was done by me, but he got it right, right? So in that case, what do you think should be your approach as a community manager? You have to take things forward, but at the same time, you are seeing that there is conflict between individuals or between ideas. What is the thing which you think can apply in that particular scenario? People are fighting. Let's say your two best friends are fighting. How is your approach? Those two are your best friends, right? You cannot choose sides. Then what do you do? Okay. What else? Calm down people. Okay. How?
By looking into the reality or the real contribution who is involved. And
okay.
Try to pacify them in terms of the contribution which has been made by one over the another one.
Okay. What else?
So usually if someone's not feeling like they're being heard, so it's about listening and really understanding what someone is trying to get across to.
Okay.
Yeah, I was gonna second that as well. Ensuring that people have their perspectives heard, so possibly getting them to rephrase it in a way that speaks. Try and not focus on the facts, because then it can end up into a blind side.
Okay, so my solution, which I have used over the years, is open communication and documentation. Let's say there is some conflict in some part of the project. Okay, use open communications to document everything. why has the conflict happened in the first place? Getting those two parties together and using open communications try to solve the conflict. Because they might be really important stakeholders for your project going forward. And that's the reason you cannot disappoint anyone. In that case, I have used documentation and the way of open communications as the next step forward. Okay, yes.
When you say the way of open communications, what do you mean specifically? So
getting them on the same table, asking them what is wrong, documenting what is wrong, and documenting your suggestions and recommendations. And let's say that if the two individuals or the two stakeholders agree on one point, saying that this was the cause of conflict, the chances for me in the past few years were that once they understood why both of them were fighting in the first place, things get clear very easily once you have them on the same table. Okay.
Clearing the expectations.
Yes. But never ever let the conflict spread. If you see the conflicts happening inside the project, never ever underestimate or try to avoid it. Jump. As a community manager, you have to jump there and then and solve the issue right away, because it might affect the future of your project. Conflict resolution, I can speak for 1 hour, but I don't have that much of time. But yes, it's a very big topic, but the only solution is getting everyone together on a common ground, which I have used so far. Okay. And the responsibilities of community manager. What do you think would be the responsibilities of a community manager? Maintaining the community.
Taking the project forward.
Taking the project forward. Creating documentation for the project.
Maintaining harmony.
Maintaining harmony, as in conflict-free. Okay. What else could be underlining thing of any community manager? The responsibilities of community managers.
Communications.
Okay. These are very simple questions. I know the answer. Everyone knows the answer. Please speak. Yep. Anyone wants to give a try? Communications, projects, documentation,
managing relationships,
maintaining the project forward. Yes? Anyone wants to add more responsibilities?
Building trust in the
team. Trusting? Okay. I'll quickly move forward. I'm very sorry for it. Approach. How do you think should be the approach of community manager? You cannot be dictative. You cannot be running behind everyone. What should be the approach of community managers? Okay. Transparent, open.
You have to follow your own rules.
Okay. Rules, frameworks, guidelines.
Ask more questions than dictate. So as often as you can, try and get the entire community's opinion.
Okay. Anyone has more answers to this approach? Watchful eye, okay. Engagements, relationships, okay. Challenges. Okay, time zone could be one challenge. Yes, what else? What else do you think could be a challenge of community manager?
Different cultures.
Cultures, okay.
Time commitments. If you have a job, 9 to 5 on top of the
game. Okay, priorities. Okay, what else?
Neurodiversity.
Neurodiversity, okay. Any more thoughts on challenges?
Lack of engagement.
Lack of engagement, okay. Okay.
Or too much engagement.
Okay. Getting everyone on the same board. Okay.
Having difficult conversations with people.
Critical conversations. Yes, that's important. Okay, so far any questions? Yes.
Budget?
Yes, budget is very important for any community manager. You cannot promise anything which is not in your hands. And budget is something which most of the community managers face an issue with. Budget usually is related to the successment of the project. And the stakeholders, when it comes to community, might not get as much as it can. Okay, there is always a budget deficit when it comes to community engagements, and that's the reason budgeting should be very wisely handled as a part of community manager. Okay. Yes. Any questions so far with challenges, or you want to say something about challenges? Conflict resolution, openness, documentation is something which I have personally followed over the years. Right. And this is very important. As a community manager, you have always, the priority task is maintaining and scaling the community. If community is not inside the project, your job, what are you going to manage, right? And that's the reason maintaining the existing community and scaling it up is prime responsibilities of community manager. Right? Scaling the community is getting more people on board, reaching out to other contributors, telling them the idea, the goal of the community, what is expected of the project. And once you have people on board, you are trying to scale the community. Okay. So maintaining and scaling the community are very important parts of any community manager. Okay, any questions? I'm done with the time. Very sorry for that. Thank you everyone. I'm sorry I could not manage time, so time management is also an important factor for community managers. Thank you.